got some rather disturbing news regarding the MMA world and former UFC heavyweight Rob Broughton. He will now spend 8.5 years in prison for his association with a drug ring. So just a little bit of information on this that was going on. This drug ring, it involved millions of dollars of cash and cocaine. Broughton, he was arrested in connection with the criminal ring run by the brothers Allen and John Tobin, who reportedly supplied huge amounts of drugs to various gangs around England. Now, Broughton, he was convicted and he was served as muscle and enforcer for the Tobin brothers, and he transported large amounts of cash and collected debts from people who owed them. Broughton had moved an estimate, get this, Nate, ready? 30 million euros in cash, over $41 million in US money. And he was also lending out his services to Anthony and Leon Cullen, who led a heavily armed drug gang in England. And between 2016 and 2020, police finally stopped a massive shipment of cocaine, reportedly valued around 20 million euros. And while Broughton didn't have a direct interaction with the drugs, he didn't enforce unpaid debts. Now, again, you know what, Nate? Let me start off with this first. Before I say anything, the source for this article was SB Nation MMA Fighting Newswire. So let me start off with this. Absolutely disgraceful. Absolutely. See, here's what I don't get, Nate. All right. I don't understand. Like, I don't understand why athletes would go to this. I don't understand why anybody would go to this. Because here's the thing, okay? These people who sell drugs, okay, I get it. But when you're selling drugs for gangs, that is some serious stuff. Okay, that means once you're in, it's really hard to get out. Okay, and when it's really hard to get out, and when you want to leave, they're not going to let you leave. Why? Because you're an asset to them, so they're not going to let you leave. It's a simple, most likely they won't let that happen. And the fact that it's a drug ring, that just makes it even worse. And look, man, it's very, very unfortunate because again, you were an MMA fighter, ex-UFC fighter. Okay, maybe who knows? Maybe money was he was low on money and he needed to do something. But you know what? This is not the way to do it. Working for these types of drug rings, you know, it's very, very unfortunate, Nate. It really is. I understand why he was an enforcer, why he was almost like that type of guy, as like kind of like a. I understand why he was an enforcer because again, he's such a big dude. You're a trained fighter, you know. So it'd be nice to have a guy as an enforcer like that. But the thing is, like when you're working, you should not be working for these types of drug rings, no matter who you are. Okay, because the second you peed him off. Just like that, with a snap of a finger, it could be all over for you. Simple as that. And again, it's very unfortunate that he's got to spend 8.5 years in prison. Now, again, I don't know what he's gonna do. I don't know. Maybe down the line he ends up like snitching or ratting out somebody to get extra less time. I'm not sure, Nate, but look, people go into this type of stuff. It really is unfortunate. You know, I remember college kids from like three colleges were involved in like a Mexican drug ring and they ended up getting caught and they were going to prison. But the thing is, look, you can't blame it on anybody because if you do, they know you as a snitch, a rat, and they are going to have a target on you. It's as simple as that. Look, man, it's very unfortunate. And this is the most interesting thing about this article, Nate. I seen a quote from the judge himself. And the judge said, well, the judge's name, before I say anything, his name was Garrett Byrne, and he said, and I quote, "I've no doubt you have a keen sense of letting your family down, and I hope when you're released, you have their best interests utmost in your mind." So yeah, that really surprised me, Nate, that the judge would say that is because, and look, after the 8.5 years he spends in prison, am I to say that Rob Broughton cannot turn into a better guy? I'm not gonna say that, okay? Because everybody, again, can change. Everybody can change. You know, everybody's made mistakes in their life and they can change from that. But it's up to Rob Brown to do that after the 8.5 years. But like we say, you got to make the right choices. You have to, because the wrong choice that he made is giving him 8.5 years in prison. You know? And to all you guys who think like, you know, selling drugs is cool or selling drugs is a great way to make cash, it's a great way to get money till you get caught. Until you don't have that money no more. Until the only thing that until you made so much money. You got caught, and the only thing that you have to show for it is a cell, or my bad, is a box basically. That's all you have because they don't do cells no more. Nate, if you look, it's not they no longer do the bars. The cells are just like closed boxes. That's the only thing you have to show for. Okay. So in case you people think like selling drugs is a great way to make cash, think about what happens if you get caught. Okay. Now, a lot now for people who, now there are some people who sell drugs and they're like, oh, I'm never going to get caught. You say that again, Nate, until what? You get caught. It's as simple as that. And then where's your plan after that? Okay. First of all, the smart, just think about it this way. Before there were drug dealers, people, there was something called mob. There was something called mobs. How many mobsters do you know that are still alive? You know, or that are not in, up and behind bars? I can name one of them. His name is Michael Franchisi or Franchise, something like that. I can't pronounce his name. That is the only mobster in the top 50 mobsters of all time that is still alive and still not in prison. Okay. Now going back to Rob Broughton, he made one choice. He's facing 8.5 years in prison for it. Now I hope that when he gets out of prison, I hope he changes his life, okay? Because like you said, like the judge said, you had a family and you let them down. Hopefully, when you get out, you have their best interests, you have their best interests in your mind, and they won't do stuff like this again. You know, look, I understand people struggle. You know, people are sometimes they're low on money or they can't. I'm not sure if that's what happened with Rob Broughton, but I know that that's the type of thing that leads people to go sell drugs and everything like that. You know, which is why, you know, it's a very sad thing to see, but it's not, but I never say anything like they're never gonna change. You have the right to change, but if you're gonna make money, okay, I know it's tough, do it the right way, because this is not the way to do it. Okay. Some people, they do this type of stuff to make barely to make ends meet for their families. Okay. And it's a great, and don't get me wrong, it pays a lot. It's a great way to make ends meet, you know, but there's two problems. A, it's illegal, and B, when you get caught with it, how are they going to be supported? It's as simple as that. So look, man, you know what? It's very unfortunate. I can't believe he was a part of something this big as an MMA fighter. He's going to have to spend 8.5 years in prison. That's very unfortunate, but you know what? Crime deserves the time. And hopefully when he gets out, he can learn from this mistake that he made and he can become a better person from it.
You're done, right?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. I don't even know what to say. I really don't even know what to say. And of course, okay, I'm not gonna hold him to the standard that this is always gonna be forever, but come on, dude. Come on, dude. This is why I tell people never join gangs. Because this is the kind of stuff that you get into. You get into selling drugs, you know, in some other cases, you know, you get into the if you know, quote unquote, thug life gang with the guns and all that stuff. That's why I tell people to put the guns down. You know what I mean? You get involved in stuff like that, someone's gonna end up shot and killed. You know, things with drug rings like this, you're gonna end up with drugs in your hand. Now, I don't know if he was doing drugs, I can't tell you that because the article doesn't say that, but he still had drugs on him. Needless to say, it's illegal, like you said. And you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. It is a great way of money. But like you said, it's illegal. And too, once you get caught, you have nothing left to show for it. So once you get caught, what do you do then? Oh, actually, there's really nothing you can do. You go to jail. But you get my point. It's gosh. Put the damn drugs down. All right? $41 million. 41 million, 30 million euros. If you, for all you Europeans out there. But for us, that's $41 million in US dollars. You know what that money could have went to? That money could have went to charities. It could have went to hospitals. It could have went to donating to science for, you know, to find things like cure for cancer or cure for COVID if you want to go that far. All that money could have went to all those things. But it didn't. It went to drugs. It went to drugs that are probably going to kill people. Because they're not smart with it. It's recreational. You know what I mean? Like that money could have went to something so much more useful. That's a lot of money. $40 million is a lot of money. And I can only imagine what it's gonna look like if an athlete does this 10 years down the road. Because look at the kind of contracts again, you know, and I mentioned that because again, you know, I don't know again, I don't know if he was struggling with money, but say he wasn't. This dude was in the UFC, you know. These athletes get paid big bucks, you know what I mean? They get paid big bucks, especially today. With these $500 million contracts or you know, $400, $300 million. It's a lot of money. You know what I mean? Like, and the reason why I mentioned that is, of course, say he wasn't struggling with money. You know, that just makes it even worse. But I'm saying say that because, again, you don't know if he was struggling with money or not. You know what I mean? And again, you're in the UFC, you probably got paid pretty well. You know, and it's just unfortunate. I hate seeing athletes do it the most, and I've said this many, many times. I hate it when celebrities do this stuff because people look up to you. You're a voice for the voiceless. You know, you inspire others to do things that, you know, we think is impossible. And then you go out and do stuff like this. Like, come on. That's not, that's, it's unnecessary. You feel what I'm saying? But look, again, I'm gonna end, there's really not much else for me to say because Mario basically covered it all. I'll say it like this, okay? I'm just gonna say it the way the judge said it. You know, you let people down, take these 8 years to think about what you did, and then just be better. That's all I gotta say. You know what I mean? I'm not gonna hold him to the standard. This is the way he's gonna be forever. You can, I'm not, because I know where my morals stand, but I'm not gonna judge you guys. But look, you know, I hope he figures it out. You know, I hope once he gets out, he's a better person. For you guys out there, make the right damn choices. Put the guns down, put the drugs down, and actually do something productive. And I know most of you probably do, but you know, even if it means resorting to each sport, I don't care. So long as you're grinding and doing it the right way, you feel me? Stay away from the guns, stay away from the drugs. It's that simple. That's all I ask.